Hello guys, welcome to Easy Electrical. In the previous lecture of DC machine, we will discuss about the constructional detail of DC machine and see the various part of DC machine in detail. Now in this lecture, we will start from EMF equation of DC machine. Okay, EMF equation, or we can say that the electromotive force equation in the DC machine. So in the case of generator, we have an induced EMF in armature. Okay, then the induced EMF in armature is called EMF. Okay, generated EMF. Or we can say that the induced EMF in the armature is denoted by EG, generated voltage in armature section. And in the case of motor, an induced EMF in armature is denoted by EB, back EMF. Okay. For the process of induced EMF in the armature, I'll discuss in the later lectures. Okay, now an armature rotates, the voltage generate in the coils. Okay, like we have a two pole machine, this is the N pole, this is the south pole. Okay, and here the armature. Okay, now here the armature conductors like this, and here key slot for the shaft. Now when armature rotate in the magnetic field, which is directed from N to S like this. Okay, now in the magnetic field, when placed via conductor in moving condition, we have induced EMF in rotor conductor, or we can the armature conductors. Okay, so this is the principle of Faraday's law. Now let's the flux produced by one pole N. Okay, one pole is phi. Phi is flux per pole. Okay, now next P, number of poles. Third one is Z, the total number of conductor in armature section. Okay, then N is speed. Okay, speed, and then A is the parallel path, number of parallel path. So first of all, we discuss about the number of parallel path. Okay, the what is the number of parallel path in a rotor armature section? Okay, so first of all, we have two type of winding. First is lap winding, and the second one is wave winding in the armature section. Okay, so in the lap winding, we have a high voltage, and actually in the lap winding we have a high current and low voltage. Okay, like this. For the high low voltage and high current, we connect the windings in the parallel like this. We have each winding we have two conductors. Okay, like this, and connect into the parallel. Then the current in each winding, like I1, I2, I3, I4, the value of current is very high, but voltage is low. okay, where the value of I is I1 plus I2 plus I3 plus I4. Okay, in the left winding, the number of parallel path, this is the parallel path, this is the first parallel path, this is the first parallel path, this one the second parallel path, this one is third parallel path, and the last one is fourth parallel path. Okay, we have a four parallel path. So in the lap winding, when we have a four pole motor, so we have a four parallel path. So we can say the in the lap winding, the value of A is equals to P always, because in the lap winding case of in the lap winding, the number of parallel path is equal to the number of pole in the machine. Now talking about the wave winding, here the conclusion is the voltage level is low, voltage level is low and the current level is high. Okay, compared to wave winding like this. So now discuss about the wave winding. In the wave winding, we have a high voltage and low current. So the winding conductors are connected in series. Okay, like this. Okay, we have a current I1, I2 or I, but the voltage is like plus minus V1, V2, V3, ... Vn. So here the voltage level is high, but the current level is low. And in the wave winding, we have only two parallel paths. This is the first parallel path. And this one is the second parallel path. Okay, and the value of I is only I1 plus I2 and the voltage level is high. So in the wave winding, the number of parallel path is always 2. A, the value of A is 2. Okay, and here the voltage level is high. Voltage level is high and the current level is low compared to both of winding, the lap winding as well as wave winding. Okay, so here the we understand the concept of number of parallel path in the DC machine. Now discuss, move on EMF equation. So here actually we have a total number of conductor is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, this will actually I consider this is the four pole motor. Okay, the four pole motor, we have a four parallel path and each parallel path we have two conductor. Okay, so total number of conductor is Z, which is equals to 8. Okay, and the how many number of parallel path is 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4. The value of A is 4. So the value of Z by A is, we can say that the number of conductors in each parallel path is 8 by 4 is equals to 2. So the Z by A is denoted by number of conductors in each parallel path. Number of conductor in each parallel path. Okay. Now the generated EMF per conductor is, move on. So first is generated EMF on per conductor is the flux cut, total flux cutting upon time taken in one revolution. Okay, the total flux cutting, total flux, okay, total flux per revolution upon time taken per revolution. ओके सो द टोटल फ्लक्स इज phi इज द फ्लक्स पर पोल. ओके एंड व्हेन वी मल्टीप्लाई विद द पोल वी हैव अ टोटल फ्लक्स. द पी phi इज टोटल फ्लक्स अपॉन टाइम टेकन टाइम. ठीक है ओके फॉर द टेकन टाइम सिंस द एन रेवोल्यूशंस मेड इन 1 सेकेंड सो द 1 रेवोल्यूशन इज मेड इन 1/n seconds. ओके सो द 1 रेवोल्यूशन इज मेड इन 1/n seconds. द वैल्यू पुट 1/n इज इक्वल्स टू एन पी phi. ओके एक्चुअली दिस इज द स्मॉल n. ओके बिकॉज वी टेक इन RPS. सो द वैल्यू ऑफ एन पी phi इज इक्वल्स टू ई आर. नाउ द टोटल वोल्टेज टोटल वोल्टेज is equals to the average voltage per conductor. The voltage per conductor is np phi multiply with total number of conductor number of conductors in per series path, which is z by a. okay so this is the generated voltage in the armature section. For the RPM, here we will take N by 60 P phi into Z upon A. This is the ER, where the N is speed in RPM. Okay, here the N is RPS. Revolution per second, revolution per minute. Okay, so by the arranging N P phi upon 60 Z upon A. This is the formula for the generated EMF for in the case of generator and as well as the back EMF in the case of motor. So this is the EMF equation for the DC machine. This is the easiest way to explain this equation, how to derive it and how to use it. Okay. Now move on the methods of excitation in DC machine. Okay. The methods of excitation in DC machine. Okay. So we have two types of excitation. First of all, the self excitation or separately excitation. Okay, first is separately excitation. And the second one is self excitation. Okay, in separately excitation, we have in a separate field winding for the excitation in DC machine like this. First of all, I draw an equivalent diagram of DC machine. Okay, so in the case of DC machine, we can say in the case of generator, we have an armature voltage which is denoted by EG. I'll draw the armature. Here the voltage is EG. Okay. And we have an armature resistance RA. Okay. And in the case of separately excitation, we have an excitation like this. This is the field winding. Okay. This is the armature winding like AA dash. This is the field winding F double F. Field winding. This is the armature winding. Armature resistance. Okay. Here we have the terminal voltage VT, your generated voltage EG. Okay, the value of VT is EG minus IaRa, because here the armature current Ia, like this. Okay, this is the separately excited DC machine, because the the excitation is separately. Okay, for the excitation we have put another DC like this. Okay, now in the self excitation we have this is the armature resistance, armature. Okay, for the self excitation the field windings also connected with the armature terminals like this. Okay, and here the terminals like VT terminal voltage, the field winding, the resistance of field winding is RF, RA. Here the in the case of generator we have an IA which is IL load current and IF field current. This is the field winding and this is the armature winding, armature. And I have put up a hash lines on the side of armature section which is donated by the brushes. These are called brushes. Okay, so in the self excitation we have two types. So first of the series excitation, for the series excitation the series winding or we can the field winding is put up in the series with the armature like this. Series excitation. Okay, in the series excitation we will put the field winding into the series with the armature like this. Armature, armature resistance, this is the field winding and the terminal voltage VT, field winding RF. Here the winding resistance RF is very high with the RA, but here the RF, the field winding resistance is mostly equal to the RA, armature resistance. Okay, this is the excitation of series excitation. Now we have discussed by the shunt excitation, this is the shunt excitation, series excitation. Now we have two conditions, compound excitations, like we have as well as a series excitation and as well as a shunt excitation. For this I'll for compound excitation. Okay, for the compound excitation we have an armature, which your armature like this. For the series winding we have a series. Here the show armature resistance, this is the RF series winding, and for the shunt I'll put up a winding in the parallel of armature and series winding. Okay, this is the RF shunt, this is the series winding, series field winding. Okay, so this type of arrangement is called compound excitations. Okay, now discuss about the electromagnetic torque equation in DC machine. Now so for the electromagnetic torque equation, okay, now talking about electromagnetic torque equation, so we have an armature power, like I put up the diagram, this is the armature, this is the resistance and here the field winding like this. Okay, I'll assume it this is the self excitation. Okay, now here the generator power is EG and the power current is IA, so the power in the armature power is, armature power is equals to EG into IA, okay, in the case of generator. Okay, similarly in the case of motor, there is no difference in the generator and motor. Okay, now this is a PA, actual power in the armature. Now we know that the electrical and mechanical relation between the power, okay, so the power is equals to torque into angular moment motion omega m. Okay, so the put up the value of PA is here, torque into omega m is equals to EGIA. Okay, so the value of torque is EGIA upon omega m, or we can say that the EGIA upon 2 pi n upon 60. Okay, this is also a valid formula. Now here we can see that the torque is directly proportional to IA. Okay, now put the value of EG from the equation, like the value of generated voltage, EMF equation of the DC machine is, the value of generated voltage is NP phi 60 Z upon A. Okay, so the put up the value of EG is here, or we can say that the put up the value of EG is here, and the omega m is, okay, let's see, the torque into omega m is 2 pi n upon 60 is equals to, the value of EG is NP phi 60 Z upon A multiplied with IA, cancel out 60 to 60 n to n. Okay, so then the rest of is constant, the torque is equals to P Z upon A upon 2 pi is considered to be a constant, and the rest of is IA and phi. So the, here we can say this is the constant value, the torque is equals to K IA and phi. Okay, now from here the torque is directly proportional to the phi, and the torque is directly proportional to armature current in the case of self excitation. In the separate excitation we have only actually in the both of case, okay, but on the permanent magnet DC machine we have only armature current directly proportional to not to the phi, because the flux is constant in the permanent magnet DC machines. Okay, so this is the formula of torque equation of DC machine. So guys, in the next lecture we will discuss about the different type of machines in DC. Okay, and we'll see the what is the shunt machine, the series DC series machine. Okay, so we will meet in the next lecture. Please like this video and subscribe this channel. Thank you so much.